Working at Google as a software engineer, it was my dream job too, but after joining in 2022, I saw gaps between the dream and reality. I'll share my firsthand experiences about the dark side of engineering excellence, why promotion systems turn even smart people into actors, and how Google's internal tools can quietly trap your skills and stall your productivity. One, brilliant engineering forgotten users. Look, Google's engineering is genuinely world-class. I saw this firsthand. It's more than just good coding. It's a disciplined craft. Code reviews meticulously dissect nuances like naming conventions and optimization strategies with automated style checks, enforced clarity, consistency, language-specific best practices, design docs dissecting edge cases most companies wouldn't even consider. It's really rigorous and impressive. But this obsession has a dark side. We often confuse perfect engineering with solving real problems. But the truth is, your code isn't your product. Your actual product is defined by the problem you solve for your users, the value you deliver to your clients, the meaningful impact you create beyond the technology. Take Gemini as an example, Google's flagship AI. It perfectly shows the gap between what's possible and what users actually get. Behind the scenes, Gemini's capabilities are extremely powerful. When you use AI Studio, the developer-focused interface, you can process up to 1 million tokens with the Pro version. That's more than 5 times the token capacity of competing platforms like ChatGPT and Claude. Gemini supports multimodal input seamlessly, handling text, code, images, and videos effectively. Complex, multi-step tasks are handled reliably, minimizing interruptions from technical limits or rate issues. Gemini is top-ranked on the Chatbot Arena leaderboard and Artificial Analysis AI, outperforming other models. However, the consumer-facing Gemini app demonstrates a common Google challenge clearly. The core model is impressive, but the actual app and user experience fall short. Many users walk away thinking, "That's it? This is Google's big AI play?" The free version limits users to roughly 32,000 tokens, far below the 1 million token capacity in AI Studio. Even worse, the UI stops at just around 10k. No raw video or audio uploads, only YouTube links or live camera clips. Although conversations typically persist after locking your device, occasional bugs disrupt reliability. It's like having a Ferrari engine inside a shopping cart, impressively powerful, but severely limited by poor execution and frustrating user experience. I learned the same lesson the hard way on my own team as well. For over 2 years, we built infrastructure to detect data corruption, processing billions of records with Google-grade reliability. We followed every best practice, code reviews upholding the strictest standards, design docs covering scaling scenarios years ahead, architecture so clean it could have served as a textbook example. From a technical perspective, sure, it was a success. But practically, we spent over 2 years perfecting a system that required massive ongoing maintenance, added complexity for adopting teams, and ultimately just wasn't critical to their workflows. When reorgs hit, guess what? Our project got cut. Not because it was bad engineering, but because great engineering doesn't equal to indispensable product. 2. Performance reviews. Impact or acting? We realized great engineering alone isn't enough because performance reviews aren't about code elegance. They are about perceived impact. Google performance reviews heavily emphasize impact. But what exactly counts as impact? In theory, it's solving real user problems or driving genuine improvements. In performance reviews, however, impact often comes down to how well you tell your story, something your manager and their manager can easily get behind. But just because your performance review paints your work as transformative and wins approvals in a promo packet doesn't mean it actually solves user problems. To be fair, many Google software engineers genuinely care, passionately dedicating themselves to solving real problems and delivering meaningful outcomes, especially in the early years of Google. But now that Google is so large, the system can nudge you toward a bit of acting, packaging your work in buzzwords and flashy accomplishments, instead of focusing on clear, measurable user benefits. You know the scene, performance season rolls around, and suddenly everyone's work is transformative, groundbreaking, critical infrastructure. Even when deep down, we quietly question, did this actually move the needle for anyone? And managers, understandably, they're often influenced by this perception too, because demonstrating their team's impact can also affect their own career progression. There's another issue. Sometimes people champion a project primarily for promotion, but once promoted, they have little incentive to maintain or further develop it, causing the project to stall and leaving unresolved issues for others to handle. All of these create a cycle where how effectively work is communicated or highlighted can sometimes overshadow the tangible results achieved, unintentionally shifting attention away from genuine problem solving. 3. Internal tools, Google's double-edged sword. Google's internal tools like Borg, Blaze, and many others are incredibly powerful. They abstract away complexity, providing incredible infrastructure. But here's the catch. That strength often comes at a cost. At Google, you're not allowed to use external tools like Slack, GitHub, or Jira. It's strictly internal solutions for security reasons. While efficient, it means you end up mastering Google-specific systems rather than broadly useful technologies. Senior engineers, even those with nearly a decade of experience, have told me they find these specialized skills less helpful when leaving Google, so it can definitely feel like your skills aren't very transferable, which makes it harder if you ever decide to switch roles in the industry. Another issue. Ever seen this meme? The title is, "Your software architecture is as complex as your organization." Honestly, it's not just funny, it's genuinely accurate for Google. For example, on my own team, we built pipelines to ensure data integrity, but to read data, we had to rely on internal tools. There were several data reading tools, but none was perfect. Eventually, we chose one that worked for us, but it could only read data from Spanner. So if a team didn't store data on Spanner, we couldn't support them as a client. And when the tool broke or was under maintenance, we were stuck waiting. We couldn't fix it ourselves because it's owned by another team. Our clients suffered downtime and our work slowed down. And the data reading tool was just one of the many tools my team depended on to complete our task. Each one introduced its own benefits and constraints. It's kinda ironic, the very tools meant to make us fast and efficient often trap us with dependency issues, slowing things down and limiting what we can achieve. The good stuff. Despite these challenges, of course, there are great things about Google. My colleagues were incredibly smart, supportive, and some of the nicest people I have ever met. When I joined, I was amazed at how welcoming everyone was. They truly went above and beyond. And let's be honest, the perks were fantastic. Free food, 3 meals a day, with chef's specials every day, game rooms, creative and inspiring office spaces, massage chairs. Google knows how to take care of its employees. More than anything, there was a genuine pride in wearing that Google badge. The name itself carries enormous weight, and that feeling is something I genuinely miss. Yet, Google today feels very different from its early days when innovation and energy seemed limitless. Maybe this shift is just a natural part of growing into a massive organization? That's just my experience, though. I'm curious, do you think it's inevitable for companies to lose some of its innovative spark as they scale? Or do you see things differently? If there's something I shared that resonated with you, or something you disagree with, I'd like to hear your thoughts. Drop a comment.